Hello everyone, this video is presented by Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Sri Balaji College of Engineering and Technology, Jaipur. We study here about the subject distributed system, which comes under 6th sem of BTech. Now, definition of distributed system. A distributed system is a collection of independent computers that appear to its user as a single coherent system. It means multiple computers seems like a single computer. Important aspects of the definition are: number one, a distributed system consists of components that are autonomous. Number two, user think they are dealing with a single system, which is the definition of distributed system. It means a distributed system is look like a single system which work with multiple number of computers. Now here is structure or architecture of distributed system, in which distributed system layer is served as a middleware with multiple number of local operating system. Here is showing multiple number of local operating system is work on a single network. We can accept any capabilities of local operating system. This diagram is given the name a distributed system organized as middleware. The middleware layer extends over multiple machines and offer each application the same interface. Examples of distributed system. Number one, web search. Major growth industry in the last decade, 10 billion per month for global number of searches. Complex for searching a big database with 63 billion pages. Number two, massively multiplayer online games. Large number of people interact through the internet with a virtual world. Challenges include fast response time, real-time propagation of event like PUBG game. Financial trading provide real-time access to a wide range of information sources such as current share price and trends. Economic and political development news. Challenges include how to deliver event reliably and in a timely manner to a very large number of clients. Characteristics of distributed system. Concurrency, no local jobs, independent failure. Concurrency, constant execution of jobs, no global jobs, coordinate actions and synchronization. Independent failure, hardware, software failure, protection, recovery and goal. A distributed system should be easily accessible, high performance, then resources are distributed across a network, distribution transparency, open and distribution transparency. The main goal of distributed system is to hide the fact that it process and resources are physically distributed across multiple computers. A distributed system that is able to present itself to user and application as if it were only a single computer system is said to be transparent. Types of transparency. There are different types of transparency. Access transparency, location transparency, migration transparency, relocation transparency, transparency, concurrency transparency, transparency. Degree of transparency. A gap between a high degree of transparency and the performance of a system. Full distribution transparency is simple impossible. Openness. Degree to which new resource sharing service can be added and made available to the user. An open distributed system is a system that offers service according to standard rules that describe the syntax and semantics of those services. A system offers services according to standard rules and such rules are formalized in protocols. In distributed system, services are generally specified through interface, which are often described in an interface definition language. So, this interface definition language is IDL. For example, Facebook Trip Protocol Buffers. Scalability. One of the most important defined goals for developer of distributed system can be measured along three different dimensions. Number one, with respective size, means we can easily add more users and resources to the system. Geographically scalable system, in which user and resources may lie far apart. Administratively scalable, means it can still be easy to manage even if it spans many independent administrative organizations. Challenges. Application distribution, heterogeneity, security, scalability, failure handling, reliability, concurrency, transparency and management. Distributed computing algorithms and their level of abstraction. There are different levels of abstraction from high to low. We discuss here. Number one is object space collaborative application. Number two is network services, object referent program and mobile agent. Number three, remote procedure call, remote method invocation. Number four is client server peer to peer. Number five is message passing. They are reduce the abstraction for distributed computing paradigms. Paradigms for distributed applications. Number one, message passing paradigm. Number two, client server paradigm. Number three, peer to peer paradigms. Number four, message system paradigms. And number five, remote procedure call paradigms. These all paradigms are used to communicate with each other. How two computers in a distributed system can communicate with each other is defined by these paradigms. Here we show the diagram for these paradigms that are message passing paradigm. When process A and process B communicate with each other, they are communicated by using message. The message are M1, M2 and M3. Client server paradigms. Client server are client host and server host. Client request for services and server provide the response for client's request. Next, peer to peer. Peer to peer communication is done by process 1 and process 2. Process 1 act like client and server, and process 2 also act like client and server in peer-to-peer communication. So here is showing request response cycle in both between both process 1 and process 2. Here is message system paradigm. In message system paradigms, there are message system by which sender and receiver can communicate with each other. Receiver can contain multiple number of queue on which message can assign.